그리고 조병선 선수를 잡아냈습니다. 아이 경기 시작하기 전에만 할 줄 알아도 이 조병선 선수 오늘 뭐 이용호 선수 만나서 충분히 뭐 가능성 있고 엔트리 잘 냈는 이야기 있었는데
예.
이용호 선수가 이겨버리니까 쏙 들어와버리네요.
그렇습니다. 이용호 선수가 빌드도 좋게 출발을 했고 또 상대방도 역시 잘 따라왔습니다만은 출발에 상대방을 묶어놓고 뭐 추가 벌지를 빨리 하는
네.
야, 야 신성훈 인정해요.
야, 이 결을 세서는 신동원 선수 가장 많은 출발을
그렇죠.
보이는데
네.
아이고 신상훈이 나왔네요. 저 그때를 잡으러
10번 나왔거든요. 신동원 선수가 10번 나와서 8승 1패 좋은 성적을 거두고 있기 때문에 KT에서 봤을 때는 신동원이 나와서 인정을 잡아야지
네.
아마 그런 생각을 했을 것 같은데 신상훈 선수가 나왔고 신상훈 선수의 적은 연승 연습도 연승이지만 70% 우승률을 지금 유지를 하고
그렇죠.
있습니다.
최근에 이재동도 잡았고요.
네. 다시 말해 엔트리를 CJ 두세 잡고 잘 냈다는 네. 얘기를 할 수 있는 거예요.
그렇죠. 엔트리 잘 내고 이제 성공을 좀 해야죠.
예, 임정현 선수 같은 경우는 이제 신동훈 선수를 노리고 나왔을 텐데 그것을 알고 있다는 듯 신상훈 선수 카드를 냈고 신상훈 선수 같은 경우는 출산 정전이 62%에 다다를 만큼 강한 이런 정액에 강한 선수거든요.
네.
어쨌든 노립수가 통하지 않았기 때문에 임정현 선수 테라를 상대로 승리를 거둬줘야 됩니다. 이용호 선수가 조명수 선수 압도하면서 승리를 거둬준 이 분위기만 임정현 선수가 중간에서 두 번째 세트에서 이어가줄 수 있다면은
네.
분명히 KT 롤스터 CJ 투수를 상대로 고전하는 게 아니라 압승을 거둘 수 있는 이런 상황이 만들어질 수 있는 거예요.
그렇죠. 이 신상훈 마저도 잡아내야 됩니다만 엔트리 뭘 내고 상관없이 임정현 선수는 제 역할만 하면 되는 거예요.
그럼 정말 악몽이 되겠죠. CJ 투수 같은 경우는 엔트리를 좋게 냈음에도 불구하고 계속 진다.
네.
이러면 오늘 애경이라도 가겠습니까? 못 가요.
볼대로 보이게 만들어줘야 되는 그런 인물을 띄고 지금 추격한 임정현 선수
그렇죠. 네. 어찌됐든 이카루스에서는 테란이 적에게 좀 안 좋은
예.
뭐 안 좋다고 얘기하기 좀 뭐하지만은 종족 상승사 테란 조금에도 불구하고 스코어가 밀리고 있거든요. 이런 부분들은 분명히 임정현 선수에게 좋은 이점으로 작용을 할 수가 있습니다.
그렇죠. 자, 임정현 선수가 지난 경기 이정 선수 대결에서
네.
아쉽게 패배한 걸 훌훌 털어버리고 이번 경기에서 이 신상문 선수를 잡아내야 됩니다.
그렇습니다.
신상문 선수가 최근에 저우전 좋아서요.
예, 그러니까 문제라는 거죠. 결국 이 이카루스에서 어쨌든 뭐 자리의 어떤 그 위치도 굉장히 경기력에 영향을 미치기도 하지만 결국 이제 컨트롤로 이제 상대방의 파워라인 다 뚫어내면서 저가 승리하는 이런 경우도 있었기 때문에
네.
확실히 임정현 선수 자신의 장기인 컨트롤에 집중하면서 신상문 선수를 혼내줘야 될 것 같고요.
그렇죠.
신상문 선수는 이번 맵에서 승리를 거두면은 신태양, 네오아즈텍, 얼터너티브 이렇게 CJ2가 승률이 높은 맵이 나오기 때문에 이번 경기에서 신상문 선수가 이기면은
예.
3, 4, 5세트 내리 CJ2가 잡을 가능성 아주 높다고 봅니다.
그냥 여기 4대1로 끝내버릴 수 있는 다리 역할을 할 수가 있어요.
그렇죠.
경기 준비 끝났어요. 2세트 대결의 시작 커리어.
5, 4, 3, 2, 1. This is the Doctor bringing you set 2 of CJ vs. KT Pro League Playoffs Day 1. We have in this game Lita vs. Crazy Hydra. Crazy Hydra is the third player at the 9 o'clock position, and Lita is the white Terran at the 12 o'clock position. So this should be a very interesting matchup. I would have to give Lita the edge. I think most people would give Lita the edge here. Crazy Hydra's coming in the correct direction with his Overlord, it looks like. A lot of CJ fans in the audience. I mean, I don't see any big KT roster posters, but there are a lot of I Love CJ posters held up by many fans. So, it looks like this is going to be on Icarus, if I had not said that already. So, and that is something Korean. Someone looks unhappy there. I do not know what team as that poster is meant to cheer for, or maybe this even today. Something's, well, that's nice. Read one word in English, the rest in Korean. That's great for someone who reads Korean, but what about me? Can't read the rest of that. Why do you bother writing today? And that's gotta be a KD fan. Otherwise, gets not necessarily, it could also be dissing KD. And that guy, yeah, he's got a, what is he doing there? And everybody around him seems to be laughing. He is, that is one stony face, I have to say. Is he, he's not a pro gamer I recognize, unfortunately. Maybe he is another pro gamer, but I mean, I hear so many people in the audience laughing. I imagine that's got to be some sort of CJ fan, though, because, you know, of that face. Of how unexpressive he was. That's got to be intentional. Anyway, Crazy Hydra playing now his extractor and his pool. Looks like overpool with gas. That is what it looks like to me, because he has your heading scouting the correct direction, which Overlord is going to veer it away just slightly. Mech build coming out from Lita here. He's put down his refinery very early. So, one base mech build. Lita loves Raves. That is his signature unit, and he is absolutely amazing with it. I have to say he is the Terran player who has the best Wraith micro of the game. And he is utterly devastating with them. I should stop saying that word so much. But Lita can use Raves, much like Zerg players use Mielis. I suspect Lita would have been one of the great Muta microers of all times, up there with the likes of Jelai Zerg and Jadong. But he chose Terran, and he is certainly a capable Terran player. When he first started out, I always thought he was way overrated. And I still think he kind of is, except that in Pro League, he's certainly very good, but he never made it far in the individual league, and that is just not good enough, in my opinion. Certainly a terror in the Pro League, but in the individual leagues, you can forget about him. He's not going to accomplish anything at this point. I'm sure all the Lita fans are going to write hate mail to me. I welcome it, in fact. You know, this is the internet, freedom of expression and all that. So I am convinced that Lita is not that great. But he is entertaining watching the Pro League. And here we see some more people here. I love my life for Entis again. That's his friend. That was the guy from game one. So two Starports going down. Yep, Lita's going for his race strategy. So we should be up for some acrobatic StarCraft and say some StarCraft ballet, if you would. Lita's race really are what artistry in StarCraft looks like, you know, reminiscent of the old days of Boxer Micro. And he is just so amazing with the Raves. He can go in and destroy Zerg opponents, really good ones too. It's not like he does this against second-rate Zerg scrubs. He does it against Jadong, for instance, way back in the Pro League series, way back in June, I believe it was, or possibly May. But some time ago, he did this two-port Wraith, one base build against Jadong. It's like, you gotta be kidding me, Lita, against Jadong. It might work on some, you know, unknown Zerg player, but against Jadong, no chance. Except Lita destroyed Jadong with it, even though it didn't go so well at first. He didn't do too much damage, but he persisted with it and really punished Jadong for taking those Wraiths too lightly. And there we see a Lita fan, a picture of a Wraith there. So clearly, nice drawing considering how quickly and there we see the, well, Lita looking quite serious there. So, excellent maneuver here, I have to say, by Crazy Hydra picking out that scouting SCV, but the Raves are already out, and Crazy Hydra is going to have to come up with something to deal with this. He does not seem to be expecting this, even though he probably should, coming from Lita. Lita going to spend some time picking off what overlords he can, and now he's going to pick away at some of these drones. Very nice to work, I have to say, by Lita. Two Raves going to cause quite a bit of damage already. Even if Scourge come out, it's not going to bother Lita too much. He, even with two Raves, he can micro them against Scourge without too much of a problem, I feel. Now Lita getting cloaked, he is going to double down on this strategy, which as would be as expected for a player of Lita's caliber with regards to their Raves. And I just don't know what Crazy Hydra is going to be able to do in this game that Jadong couldn't cope with this. He's got a few more Mielis out. Jadong went for Hydralis to try to counter the Raves. He just wasn't so good at positioning it with Mielis and Scourge. It can be effective. As Scourge sent to scout out the cloak research, the two starports getting picked off there by the Raves. But there just aren't that many Mielis out for Crazy Hydra, rather. Not Sky High, Crazy Hydra. So Crazy Hydra is going to have to spend some time, I feel, in the defensive here. He is not building anything. Is he supply capped or something? He might possibly be supply capped. That's why he wasn't building anything at his natural. Now Crazy Hydra has actually massed up a reasonable force. He's got Overlord Speed, which is going to help. And that Marine getting picked off, not going to bother Lita too much. So it's going to come down to one micro-intensive battle here, old-school style almost, I have to say. Those Mielis picking way at the And now Overlord almost getting picked off there. Lita not quite able to finish it off. How critical is that? These Ray's going to be forced back here. Rafe on Mutalisk action here. Mutalisk and Rafe unable to do too much damage to each other. Scouting SCV at the front, not getting through. And that Overlord getting picked off. But Crazy Hydra has a second Overlord at the front. Very, very tense. One mistake from either player, and this will be GG. Crazy Hydra putting on more pressure. He's only got two Scourge here. A lot more Mutalisk coming in. One more Scourge getting picked off. And those Overlords, there are three Overlords here now. I don't think Lita would be wise to go after the Overlords. He would probably be wise to pick away at the Mutalisk as best he can. He's intercepting reinforcements. Nice little maneuver there. That's got to piss Crazy Hydra off quite a bit here. And that Marine getting picked off by the Mutalisk without much of an issue. Barracks is actually in some danger of burning down. Lita is not too careful. Probably should repair that sooner rather than later. Now Lita has a lot of raves. He's probably got up to a dozen raves here against maybe a dozen Mutalisks. Both sides are losing aerial units here. But Crazy Hydra, I feel, is certainly not coming out ahead in this little exchange here. Lita was so much superior. Micro, look at that. Three volleys of missiles to one volley of glaive worms by Crazy Hydra, forcing him back. This is what I mean. Lita, utterly, I gotta stop saying that word. Lita, just astonishing with his control over his raves. Now Crazy Hydra messing up five overlords. He is paranoid about that cloak. I mean, there's no reason not to keep the overlords around his Mutalisk. If he lose all his Mutalisks, it's GG anyway. And it'd be wise to, you know, keep his overlords around air units that can protect them too. So I certainly understand that. Quite a few more units being morphed here by Crazy Hydra. He realized he can't defeat Lita in a straight up battle here. Lita probably gonna put down more barracks and transition into medic marines now. He's also got I wonder whether he should actually try for some sort of like vulture slash wraith play. The two super fast units, you use the wraiths to tie down the Mutalisks or other ground units. Well, I guess it would only really be applicable against Mutalisks. You use the wraiths to tie down the Mutalisks somewhere, and then you send in half a dozen speed vultures in main and wreck the Zerg player. Queen's Nest coming out, he's going for either Defilers or Devourers. It's one or the other here. He's not even put down a Hydralis then. So this is certainly a very unusual game for modern TVZ. Basically, you only ever see this type of game against Lita. And that is something I have to say that is a very strong advantage for Lita. Because no other Terran player, with the possible exception of Flash, can do this. Flash doesn't like to do this. And he's not the best at microing, so I think Lita would actually be better at Flash than pulling off this strategy. I only say Flash because he pulls off every possible strategy. Before there was Lita, Flash did 5-port raves, or 4-port raves against Jadong, and now Lita coming, sniping 4 overlords, 1 volley, 1 overlord kill. This is absolutely astonishing, as this game Sky High looks like an amateur, and those players completely stunned. SKT1 players looking stunned at Lita's performance in this game here. SKT1 players, especially Bisou, famous for their expressions of disbelief. Famous for their expressions of disbelief, especially Bisou. They're probably all cribbing from Bisou there with their looks. And that was just unbelievable. Queen's coming out here from Crazy Hydra. He's definitely gone crazy here. A snare can work extremely well against Wraiths. It slows them down, makes them vulnerable. Not to mention they slow down the attack rate, and they are good against Magic Marines. But Crazy Hydra, I'm not sure he can recover from that blow there. Losing 4 overlords in less than a few seconds there. You know, and Lita could probably dart back in sooner rather than later. He is going in for another run here. Gonna maybe pick off another overlord or two. And once the overlords are gone, he can have free reign all over these Mutalisks. Picking off another overlord like that, absolutely beautiful to watch. Crazy Hydra has managed to rebuild his air force. He needs a win in the next decisive engagement. I'm just not sure he's going to be able to deliver. Lita now has a good-sized infantry army. He's got a command center building. Once he gets his expansion up, it will be GG for Crazy Hydra for sure. Crazy Hydra has one opportunity to force and win a decisive battle. He's got to win it, and he can't keep bleeding units like this. Now we see Queen out with the Mutalisk. Ensnare! Oh, this is a perfect time! No! Crazy Hydra missing his opportunity of eating snare all those Mech Marines and the Rage. That would have been devastating, because then Crazy Hydra could run into the main and cause all sorts of damage, and those units can't respond. Crazy Hydra is counterattacking at the main here, and that queen getting sniped by Lita! There's no detection here! He's being able to force the turn tail and run! So many casualties! Crazy Hydra just completely not up to task of dealing with Lita here, and I was gonna say that this is an advantage for Lita. He is really the only Terran practitioner of this play. The other two players I can think of are Baby and Flash. Flash doesn't like to do this, and Baby is inconsistent, whereas Lita is perfectly consistent, sniping every Overlord in one salvo! This defies belief, I have to say. These Skunk Colonies cannot fight back against the Rage. Great snare, but too late. Just not gonna matter at this point, because Lita has infantry pouring into the natural here against all these Mielas. The Mielas are gonna do nothing against, and you can see snare buildings. That's interesting. I never knew that. But Mielas just gonna do nothing against these Wraiths. The Wraith still firing quite quickly, I have to say, even under a snare, but Crazy Hydra losing his naturals, too many infantry, and Lita looking ecstatic with himself. He should be. This is like, if you read the textbook on Wraith in TVZ, this is the game you hold up as the example of how you're supposed to do it. Crazy Hydra completely destroyed here, and Lita doing a ceremony! What the hell is going on here? Channeling his fireback hero. In a riot that hero, I have to say. And KT not looking too happy. CJ coming back convincingly in game 2. This is going to be an exciting series, I have to say, going on game 3.